Dear international students, welcome back to Full Scholarships. Today we are here with new scholarship video, and this opportunity is from Canada. So you have fully funded scholarships to study in Canada. Some of them require IELTS and maximum do not require IELTS. So you can study in Canada on scholarships with 100% fully funding scholarships without IELTS requirement. We will discuss everything in detail. And to begin to that, let me remind you again, if you have not subscribed to our YouTube channel yet, please subscribe. If you are watching this video for the first time and have not subscribed yet, please do subscribe and like this video. Also, you can get the link in the video description below, given in the video description on the top. So click in the link given in the below. So you will be redirected to our website here. Also, if you have not followed us on Instagram, please click the follow button. Also, you can message us on Instagram or watch our stories and get the link from our Instagram bio here. So once you click on the link in the video description, you will be redirected to our website here. Once you land on this page, you can read about this. You can study bachelor's, master's and PhD in Canada. So there are more than 15,000 programs and scholarships to be completed. So you can read about details of this Canada scholarships. So the funding is fully funded and deadline varies from each scholarship and each university. So you deadline varies from 2021 year to 2022. So you can apply up to 2022 March. And here are the scholarships for bachelor's, master's and PhD in Canada. So scholarships in Canada for undergraduate. So you can check Lester B. Pearson International Scholarship. This one is provided by University of Toronto. And it covers everything. The other is York University International Student Scholarship Program. We will discuss everyone in brief and we'll show you live application process for each of them. And then the next is University of British Columbia. And next is Calgary International Entrance Scholarship. And another is from University of Toronto Scholarship. So it has maximum of 4,400 scholarships. Then Concordia undergraduate awards, then Saskatchewan international awards. And similarly for masters, we have Banting postdoctoral fellowships, Canada graduate scholarships, Vanier Canada graduate scholarships, then Canada memorial scholarship, University of British Columbia graduate scholarship, it's also known by UBC. Similarly, we have University of Alberta international scholarships. Then we have University of Toronto, Ontario graduate scholarship. It's from the Ontario campus. And simply then we have University of Waterloo international funding and Ontario graduate scholarship. Next is our scholarships in Canada for PhD. So you can check Vanier Canada scholarship for graduate, Ontario Trillium scholarship and University of Alberta scholarship, University of Ottawa scholarships. Similarly, we have also mentioned work opportunities in Canada. So if you have dream to study in Canada as well as works along with these studies, we can help you in this regard. And we have listed universities in Canada without IELTS also. So here are the list of universities where you can study without IELTS. So you can check Winnipeg, Brooks and Saskatchewan, Regina, Carleton Memorial and Concordia. These have also scholarships above. So scrolling top of this page, here you can check. So we will discuss, like for masters we have in Toronto, and similarly for bachelor's also and for PhD also. So we have three scholarships in Toronto for different subjects, undergraduate, masters, and so the application is same. Only you have to choose a stream. That is, if you are applying for undergraduate, you have to apply to undergraduate section. So simply once you want to click for this Lester B. Pearson International Scholarship, simply click on this red line, mention this name here. So it's a link embedded in it. So simply click in it. It will take you to our website where you can watch previous video. As we have already mentioned this, you can watch complete application process here. Since you can scroll down, here you can check on the yellow, the link is given to apply to Toronto. So click in this link below mentioned. It will take you to the official page of Toronto University. So let me close this page. So it will take you to the official page of University of Toronto. You can check Lester B. Pearson International Student Scholarship. So that we have mentioned here. So once you go to this page, scroll down. So you can read details about scholarships and apply. So application process is also mentioned here. So here you can check apply to study at University of Toronto. Click on this button here. It will take you to apply to University of Toronto page. So you can read details about the how to apply. Now click on this applying here, mentioned in the here. Once you click on applying, it will show you the details, the requirements, international baccalaureate, and other things that you need to know before application process. So simply scroll down a little bit. You need to skip this OUAC 101 application, and next is international applicant. So as we are international applicant, so we need to apply to three through this link. So access the international application, click on this link here. Once you click here, it will redirect you to the login page. If you have previously logged in, you can use the same details. However, if you are new, you can simply sign up. So as we have previously logged in, so if you have not watched our previous videos, you can go and watch how to get the username and password and how to make the account. So as we have shown you on our website, as you can watch our previous video, you can check our playlist of Canada, there will be everything. So simply I have mentioned, so you can scroll down a little bit here, you can check create account, so you can create an account here. So now as I have already created my account, so I will use my username and password, simply then click on the login button. So let it login and let the page load. So we have been logged in successfully. So there is a criteria. Let me show you what I am talking about. So click on the applications. Let me show you what I am talking about. So you are permitted to submit one type of application only. If you submit more than one application, the University of Toronto will cancel the second application without refund. So as we have previously submitted our one application, so we cannot apply for other applications. So you can only fill single application at a one time. So as we have not paid our fees, we had just shown you in our previous video that how to fill application. So once you log in, if you have not previously submitted your application, here will be a submit an application. You have to choose course and then submit. So it's for University of Toronto. I hope you have understood the process. You need to read about these here. So you can access other OUAC. So if you have somehow access to OUAC account, you can click on that. So let me show you that also. So if you have OUAC account, you can go to application, click on that. So then you can log in with email and password. If you have not previously your OUAC account, you can create your account here. Then you can simply log in. So it's for undergraduate currently. So I am showing you for undergraduate. So like stats in Canada, like no stats, you can then click next. Okay, so at the time of applying, so I am study permit Canadian student. So we can select no stats, then click next. So student number value must contain only digits. So student number, so where is the student number? So let me check the student number. So form cannot be submitted as it contains one error. So please correct the errors and resubmit the form. So let me check the, okay, so permit, study permit. So I have a study permit, I can select that. So let me cross check this error first, student number. So currently there is some error. So let me show you where the error is. You can check, we cannot choose this. So let me reload again. This field is currently not been able to choose. So there is some error, as we also cannot apply via this 101 link, as we have to submit application via international section only. So we can only submit this application via this international application only. So you need to watch our previous video, as we have completely shown you the application process of University of Toronto. So as the application for University of Toronto is in the same way, so now we will go to this. Let me close these tabs. So now we will discuss about York University International Student Scholarship. So while you click on this link here, many people will ask about Toronto. So it's a famous scholarship preferred by African students. So once you click on this Toronto link, it will redirect to our website here. While you scroll down a little bit, here is our YouTube video. You can click and watch this video about complete application process of University of Toronto. So now we will discuss about York University International Student Scholarship Program, and we'll fill application here. Now click on this link here. It will take you to the Future Students University of York official website. So as if you are like, which one applies to you, as we are an international student, so I am an international applicant. Click on this and scroll down a little bit, read about the scholarships here, so you can check all details that you need to know. And here on the top you can check apply button. Here click on this apply button here. Once you click on apply button, it will take you to the application form section here. So you can fill OU via OUAC application center, or you can fill the York University application center here. So you can apply through via OUAC. So let me open this as well as York University application here. So here you can check OUAC system. So you can click undergraduate, graduate, law, let's suppose undergraduate, and then simply here you can check go to application. So as you can check, we were not able to submit via this, so let me close this one. So here you can check York University application system. Simply click on this apply now button here. So you can check undergraduate application form. Let me zoom it. So you can check undergraduate application form. So we need to fill name, identity, goal of study, citizenship, contact address, previous education, demographic, education, declaration, and consent. So you need to submit all the details here. And then legal first name, you need to submit all everything. That's compulsory. And let me show you this process of registration. So everything, everyone has the same process. Then you need to fill your scholarship email. Then click next. Goal of study, when do you want to start the classes? You can select the session. So towards a degree, choose the subject. I hope you are understanding the process. So you can click on next page, choose your course. So you can check courses. So you can check all courses are mentioned here. So let me find my. So I will apply to this environmental. I had seen it earlier, but I could not find it here. So let okay. So here is the environmental and urban change. So I am applying for this. Then you can add the second program also. So simply I will apply for this BA, then click on next. So citizenship, country is first language, language of correspondence, select English. And what is your official stats in Canada? So I have no stats. Then click on next. Add the address. So it's same. So then click next. So have you we have no education previously in Canada, so we can skip, click next. So demographic information, have you previously applied to York? So as we have not, so we can select no, then click next. So here is the declaration and consent. So click I agree and then click on submit. So you can check, review this and then click on confirm. So now once you make the payment, it will submit your application easily. So let's leave this here. So as we do not want to complete the transaction, as we do not want to apply to this, so you, once you complete your payment, so it will automatically submit your application. So now we will discuss about the University of British Columbia scholarship for international students. Click here on this link. It will redirect you to the official website of British Columbia University. So let me zoom in it a little bit. So here you can check University of British Columbia. So it's an official website. Now scroll out down a little bit. You can read details about the scholarships. Everything is mentioned here. So on the top, you can check apply to UBC. Click on this button here. Once you click on this, you can check complete the application process. So you can start the application here. Click on this, start the online application. So let me open it. So now you can choose the course which is available in this university. So you can click on any of the courses. Suppose I want to click for this medical studies. And here is the dentistry. Let me choose this dental science. Click on this. So once you choose your course, you can scroll down a little bit. Here you can check on the left hand side apply button. Click on this apply online here. It will take you to this application page. Now you can check. Thanks for interest in applying to undergraduate degree at UBC. Let's get started. Click on this. Let's get started here. We have also previously shown you this application process. So now click on this apply now here after you apply to UBC at Education Plan BC. So once you click on this, you need to sign up as an educational or in simply a student. Then complete the education so you can apply to any of the universities mentioned here. So you can check all the universities, but currently we are showing for University of British Columbia. So here is the university. You can click on this and then other institutes are also mentioned here. So you can simply sign up. So let me quickly show you this. So as you can check, an account provided with the email address already exists. So let's simply click on this login button here. So let's check if this takes us to the login page. The page is loading. It might take few seconds to load. So here we have already signed up. Simply we can sign in. It will authenticate and take us to the login. So let me check. So you can check, we have like 90 ago we have submitted. So let me check if we have any submitted applications. So there are no submitted. Simply click on this apply, contact, complete these details, personal details. You can then start applying as we have not completed the detail. Let me check the details first. Now selected our birth. Country of birth. It's not mandatory, but still I want to submit it so that in later there is no need to submit again. That's why I am filling it. So now country of citizenship, choose the country where you are citizen. So now click on save. So immigration status, so currently non-Canadian, status unknown, save. Now it's green, so we need to add addresses. So choose the country. You need to choose from the list. So then you can सेव. ओके सो फोन नंबर इज इम्पोर्टेंट. सो चूज द कंट्री ऑफ द फोन देन सबमिट द फोन नंबर. ओके नाउ क्लिक ऑन सेव. So you can save. Now academic history, we need to add a high school country where you have studied. So school, there will be a list. If you can't find, you can write it. So let me choose from the list. So every school is mentioned here. So date started. Then current or highest, so it's 9 and done. Then add post secondary institute. Then select institute where you completed your associate degree. So you can choose the post secondary. Then an institutional credit, so we can skip it and then simply save. Now you can click on this start applying. And now you need to choose the university as we are currently applying. You can apply to any of this, but currently we are applying for University of British Columbia. Then we need to click on this create application. So here is the reference number. Then program selection, choose the program. So you need to find your course. So you can check the courses here. So I'm into medical dentistry. So let me choose this. You can choose the second course. Then click on save. Now additional information. So if it is compulsory, then we need to submit, otherwise we can skip. So it's like gender, so not specified. Disability, no. So then university or colleges, so completed. So we can English language, have you? Yes, we have English proficiency. Which other? So you can check like university's own. So when did you completed your course, you need to select that. So scores. So then you can scroll down and then save. Let me check. So the field is required. Okay, so we are not. Now academic provision, so we have not. So then auto saving, then save. Now review and submit. So you can review the profiles. So here is an application fee. I will pay by credit card when some I have an approved fee waiver. So you can have if you have any waiver code, you can submit that. Then yes, and give permissions, then submit applications. If the code is verified, you can submit it. So fee waiver code is not. So if you have waiver code, you can submit it. Otherwise, you have to pay the application fee and your application will be automatically submitted. I hope you have understood this process also. And let me close these tabs. Now you can go to the Calgary International Entrance Scholarship or University of Toronto Scholarships. It is in the same process. So we have already shown you video here. Once you click on the link, you can watch videos. And simply other scholarships are here, like Saskatchewan. Click on this link, it will take you to the Saskatchewan University Scholarship. Here you can scroll down and here you can apply, and here you can click here to watch the video step by step. So we have also mentioned the video here. Similarly, you can check when you graduate. So it's loading. So let the page load. So here you can check value and other things. So you can simply click on any of the institutions where you want to study, then follow and log in. Simply you can check UBC. We have already shown you University of Alberta, University of Toronto, University of Waterloo. We have also shown you. You can check our previous Canada playlist. It will be in the video description below. The Canada playlist is mentioned in the video description below, and you can apply to any of the scholarships mentioned here. So you need to apply quickly as soon as possible so that the deadline does not pass. So you can apply like International Masters Excellence Scholarship, Ontario Graduate Scholarship, Ontario Trillium Scholarship, TRADU Scholarship, Vanier Canada Scholarship. So like we have mentioned here, all the scholarships here. So you can apply to them on a same portal here. I hope you understood the process and will apply to any of the scholarships so that you can save your year. So please do subscribe us and like our video and follow us on Instagram. Before leaving, I am signing off for Full Scholarships. Thank you for watching this video.